So, I've had my first clay shoot, and I must say, it was cracking fun, really, really enjoyed it. I'd recommend it to anyone, if you're wanting to do something different, even if you're not particularly into shooting, it was really good fun. This particular shoot that we went on was a 50 bird shoot, and out of the 50 I managed to hit 13 clays. So it's not a breathtaking score by any stretch of the imagination, but I'm really pleased I managed to hit that many. I wasn't expecting to get sort of any more than that. But I'm going to keep the card, and the next time I go, I'm going to see if I can improve on it, and sort of that's part and parcel of clay pigeon shooting, I guess. Went with my brother-in-law to be, and a friend, James, and he'd never shot before, and it was quite good because they helped you out a lot. There was a marshal there in particular who was giving us some tips and really sort of took us under his wing and showed us how to get on, and it was really nice to sort of feel welcome, really, in a group of people that have been meeting up there every third Sunday of every month. They sort of know each other. For new people to go and for them to be so helpful, it was really good, actually. So I'll be going back. I think the next one's on the 18th of March. I did manage to take some pictures, not a lot, and I did take some video footage of my friend using the over and under.
I'm the boogeyman, the terrible, horrible boogeyman. I come in the middle of the girl like you. Better have a care. I'm going to follow you everywhere.
No, I didn't get it.
To the ceiling and the wall and call her that little girl like you.
I took the Benelli Supernova, which I bought in October. Like I said in the last video, it's a pump action shotgun in full camo, and I took that. Now, as soon as I got there, everybody had an over and under. Everybody. I was the only one there with the pump action. And there was another bloke there with a semi-auto, but it just stuck out like a sore thumb, and I thought, well, I'll try it out, you know. Now, I can tell you now, I fell in love with that shotgun when I saw it. I wanted it, but actually shooting it at a clay shoot was, it was not really very good at all for me. It was too heavy. The action of reloading it with the pump was too slow for the next clay, and it was sort of putting me off a bit. So after sort of four or five attempts with it, I put it back in the bag, and I was using my my mate's over and under, and it was a lot lighter. It was the proper shotgun for the day, really. So on that, I went to the gunsmiths today in my dinner hour, picked up the Benelli, took it down, and I've swapped it. It's a Rottweiler. There was probably three or four shotguns in my price range. There were two that he would swap and give me money back as well, but they weren't multi-choked. The first one that I liked was too tight. The chokes were too tight. It was a quarter choke and a three-quarter choke, and they were fixed, so you couldn't change them. And he said it's too tight for anything that you're wanting to do. The group's too tight. And that was a Lincoln. Right, so I've just moved camera, got a bit closer just so you can see sort of a bit of the detail of this Rottweiler. But like I say, the side panels, I've got a bit of engraving on them, but nothing fancy. I'm guessing you can get them engraved with whatever you want if you want it. And somewhere on here, I think it's this side, it says Rottweiler. There you go, look, engraved on the barrel, which is a nice finish. Like I say, the forearm stock is perfect. There's no marks on that. Nice checkering on it. And really, apart from a few little dinks on the stock, which you can see sort of just in the light there, there's a few more on this side. That's about it, really, which is to be expected when you're sort of carrying to the batting field and taking it on shoots, chucking it back at car and that. But like I say, if I really want to, I can sort of strip it down and polish it up. It's got the safety up here, which obviously up for safety, down for off, and then your left and right on your upper and lower barrel when you want to, pardon me, to take your shot. And I'll try and take some pictures, but there's a little bit of detail, not too much. Don't know if you can make that out. It's like a little hummingbird on the trigger guard there. It's nice. It's not over the top. It's just right, just the right amount. And the rest of the barrel is lovely. No scratches on it at all. And there you see the multi-chokes that screw into the shotgun. So yeah, nice little quick look at the new shotgun. Let me know what you think. And this one actually fits in my cabinet without me taking it to bits. So it's a lot lighter and shorter. It's not a lot shorter, but it's a lot lighter than the Benelli, and it's short enough for me to put it in my cabinet without taking it to bits. So I can't wait to use it and show you what it's like. That's about it for now. I mean, I've not had a proper good look at it, but it's got ejectors on it and all that jazz, so it's really nice. Also, it's a multi-choke, like I was saying, so it's got two chokes in it. Don't know if you can see. It's got two chokes in it, and it actually come with another three chokes. Now, I don't know what these are. I'm gonna have to find out. So it comes with five chokes in all. So I'm gonna really find out what they are. I mean, there'll be half choke, quarter choke. There might be a three-quarter choke. There'll be a full choke. So I'm gonna really find out what they are. And that's it. Right, till next time, stay tuned, and happy hunting, safe shooting. See you all later, guys. See you.